Thank you very much for coming. Thank you very much, James. First of all, I would like to thank PKP and the Universitat Autònoma de Barcelona for giving me the opportunity to be here. My name is Carme Besson. I work at the Communication Library and General Newspaper Archives here in the UAB, and I'm in charge of the general coordination of all matters regarding support for teaching and research. The topic of this 20-minute presentation will be to show you the steps that the library service and its stakeholders have taken in terms of open access in recent years. I'll provide you with a brief overview of our progress. So, in 2005, open access was, let's say, a perfect stranger in the university for many researchers. At that time, there were no documents in open access. Our institutional repository didn't exist yet. But as you can see, in 2019, more than 82,000 research documents are available in our institutional repository. So things are very different, and a lot of things have happened during these 14 years. Our researchers increasingly think that open access helps to maximize the visibility of their research and show a growing interest in publishing in open access journals and in the repository as well. My presentation will focus on the main achievements, which are the ones you can see in this milestone chart. Firstly, the creation of our institutional repository, which is called the DDD. DDD stands for Deposit Digital Documents. It was created in 2006. Secondly, the institutional open access policy was approved. Only 1 year later, the Open Access Commission was a reality. In 2015, we launched our open access web. 2 years later, we decided to track the open access at the university. And working towards Plan S and the institutional research data policy are what we have been working on in the last few months. And finally, the future is outlined. So, the first milestone and a very important one is the creation of the institutional repository. It currently has nearly 200,000 records. I like to outline the main features of it. The university made a commitment to gathering its heritage, research, and institutional documentation together in the same platform. The collection management is the responsibility of the library service, while the IT service is responsible for taking care of the infrastructures. The research output of 80 UAB research groups or centers is deposited in the DDD and organized in customized collections. Our repository is 100% in open access. We have only few documents, about 200 articles, under temporary embargo. Permanent embargo is not allowed. Whether the researchers self-archive their documents or not, the library staff review all the documents and publish them in the repository according to the publisher's policies. The DDD is well positioned in rankings and maximize the visibility on the authors of the authors and their works. And finally, our digital preservation policy was approved last year, and it guarantees the access to the DDD collection in the future and entrusts the attainment of this goal to the library and the IT services. Okay, let's move on to the next milestone. In 2011, the Spanish science law came into force. Article 37 established that the final digital version of article published in peer-reviewed journals had to be accessible in the institutional repositories. To encourage compliance with the law and alignment with European universities, Most Catalan universities decided to draw up their own open access policies. Ours was drawn up by the library service with its stakeholders, and it was approved in 2012. Additionally, the university recommends the academic community to publish in open access whenever possible. And furthermore, students have to publish their final closing projects in open access in the repository as well. So, as soon as the open access policy was approved, the university became aware of the need to have an open access commission to establish a roadmap for open access. It was created in 2013 and it's commissioned by the Vice Rector for Institutional Relations and Culture. Let me elaborate on that. If you have a look at the members, you can see that Vice Rectors, the IT Service, Publishing and Library Services, Research Management Area, and Teaching or Research Staff are all represented in the commission. That means that the university is really committed to this matter. The action plan for open access is the commission roadmap detailing the actions to perform at the university in order to foster open access. Below, you can see the highlighted actions foreseen in the plan and already achieved. For instance, we have established some procedures to serve archived documents in the repository, and the intellectual property and open access information platform was created 4 years ago. It is run by the library service and it's maintained by the different services involved, including the legal office. It provides access to 200 frequently asked questions and the possibility of asking a question if you are a member of the university community. And it was time to let the world know what we were doing in open access, and we decided to create the open access web. This web gathers together all the information related to open access. So it explains what the open access is, its main benefits, good practices, and so on. This whole map is in the homepage, and the research output, hits and downloads are shown from the DVD are shown in this whole map. So I don't know if you can read at the end of the room, but I can tell you that from the beginning of this year, 2019, more than 9 million hits and 7,200,000 downloads. And in 2017, we decided to track the open access at the university. And the sources of information are the DDD, the repository, and the GRIS, the UAB Research Database. So, this tool allows us to know how the interaction of the open access at the university is evolving, and it's also an exercise in transparency. So, if you look at the figures, more than 82,000 research papers are available in the repository, more than 10,000 articles cited in the UAB research database are connected with its full text in open access in the DDD. 80 is the number of the UAB academic journals in open access in the repository, and 73 was the number of research groups and centers in the DDD at the beginning of the year. And as I mentioned earlier, today is 80. This thermometer is updated once a year, at the beginning of the year. And only some months later, some Catalan universities decided to launch the Catalan universities open access observatory based on a Polytechnic University of Catalonia and University of Barcelona proposal. This observatory aims to track the open access in the different Catalan universities. So while the sources of information in the UEB thermometer were the CRIS and the DDD, the observatory currently uses Scopus and Web of Science databases. So I like to draw your attention to the figures where you can see the evolution of the open access in my university during the last 8 years. So the gray part of the columns are the non-open access documents, while the green, brownish, gold and yellow parts are the open access documents according to the publishing route chosen. The green, the bronze, the gold, or the hybrid routes. So we think that this is a good complement to the UAB thermometer because the sources of information are different. And I wanted to tell you that soon this observatory will present the cost of researchers and universities when publishing openly. It is updated twice a year. And in 2018, Plan S arrived. As you know, Plan S is an initiative launched in September 2018. It aims to accelerate the transition to open access, and it is supported by Coalition S. As you know, international consortium of research funders. So at that point, we wanted to know how ready we were to deal with the principles of Plan S that affect our operations. And we've been working in principles 1, 4, and 6. Two main actions have been done to meet principle 1. So today we have all UAB journals in open access in our repository under Creative Commons attribution license. And we also have some UAB Creative Commons licenses recommendations to help students and teachers and to encourage them to publish using a license as open as possible. As far as Principle 4 is concerned, we've just started with financial aid thanks to bonuses and discounts on APC prices with membership fee. We have now 25% of discount for the academic community when they choose an MDPI journal to publish their research. And finally, Principle 6. The strategic plan of the library service within the framework of the strategic plan of the university sets the following two strategic priorities in this regard. The first one is to make progress in the open science field. So I'd like to digress for a moment to let you know that since the publication of the open science law, the library service has been doing in-service training related to open access for teachers, researchers, and PhD students. We have also organized some courses on demand and specific courses about open access as well, about different aspects, for the research centers who ask for them. And I explain this because if our researchers think that open access is good for their research, it will be easier to make progress in the open access in our science field. So let's go back to the strategic priorities. The second one is to contribute actively to spotlighting all scientific output. So one of the actions foreseen to achieve this second objective is to develop the DDD, the repository. And that is what we have been doing during the last months. In fact, the DDD has been implementing quality improvements according to the needs that arise and plan S criteria established. So in the next milestone, you will see that the DDD is well prepared in terms of plan S. It meets all mandatory plan S criteria established. And as for compliance with strongly recommended additional criteria, we failed to meet only one of them. So we are quite happy about it. And finally, the last milestone, which is the institutional research data policy. It will be agreed on by all the stakeholders involved in this matter. We already have a proposal, and we hope that it will be approved by the Governing Council by the end of this year. The policy will deal with the following points, the points you can see in the slide. So it will explain who is affected, it will deal with copyright and technical issues, it will establish the responsibilities of the different stakeholders involved in this matter, and so on. And after having seen what we've done, so the creation of the repository, the open access policy, the commission, the web, the two thermometers, plan S, data policy, let's have a look at the near future. This section sets out the challenges we have ahead. Let's summarize the main points. Firstly, we need to approve the data policy. Our researchers need it to meet the international research funders' requirements. And among other things, it will mean the recognition and the guarantee of our repository as the data repository as well. Eventually, an open science policy should embrace the current document and data policy to include new open science fields. To achieve this, our open access commission has to be turned into an open science commission. Next point. Our new CRIS will be launched in a couple of months. So working towards a complete interconnection between both platforms, the CRIS and the DDD, will be essential to ensure the visibility of our research. Incentives are always necessary if we want to move on, and they definitely mean that the organization is committed to open access. So, funding for researchers, publishing in open access journals, new open access memberships, and reward systems for depositing postprints in the DDD are just a few examples of what we plan to do. And last but not least, our consortium must negotiate transformative subscription with publishers to avoid double dipping and to align ourselves with planners. So, right, I think we've covered everything. So, thank you all very much for your attention.